Ever since I got my hands on the Horizon 3 dev build, the developer build of Horizon 3, I've done quite a few silly things, interesting things, but kind of silly at the same time. We built top fuel dragsters, I put batteries and electric motors into a Hellcat, I shot a Tesla into space for no reason whatsoever. But there's one thing that I never did, and that's build a race car. But not just any race car, a race car without any rules or restrictions holding it back. The ultimate race car, if you want. And the reason I've never done this is because it's borderline impossible. See, if you want to build a top fuel dragster in the Horizon 3 dev build, all you really need to change in the game files and the physics files is the power of the car, the weight of the car, the wheelbase, the tire grip, the tire size, and maybe the drag values if you want to go super fast in a straight line. It's not super easy, but it's relatively straightforward. But with a race car, you need to change almost everything, and if you change one parameter too much, the car just becomes undrivable. So there's a very fine line you can't cross, and there was only one goal here, and that's to set a new Goliath world record. And I say new Goliath world record because it turns out I wasn't the first person to try this. There have been a lot of people who spent a lot of time to build a dedicated modded race car to go round Goliath as fast as possible. In fact, I did some digging. We have an unofficial leaderboard, and I say unofficial leaderboard, and this is very important. All of those times are completely offline, and that's because the game itself, the dev build, is cut off from any online features. So we're not going to ruin any leaderboards here. This is just a fun competition between a few friends and YouTubers. And speaking of friends, we've got Nick, AO12, 7 minutes 57 in a modded ACR Viper. We've got Ace of Kings, 7 minutes 29 in a 5,000 horsepower Centenario. And then we have, you know, 6 minutes 41, 6 minutes 16, 6 minutes 11, 6 minutes 10, Glitcher 101 Gaming. And then we have Cho with 5 minutes and 37 in another modded Centenario. Now, as you can see from the leaderboard, even if you can change any value you can think of in the files, if you can do anything you want and you have loads of time to prepare, it's really difficult to go sub 6 minutes. Only one person has done it so far. Now, to make this challenge a bit more difficult for myself, I decided not to pick the best car in the game, the Lamborghini Centenario. I went with this, a Lamborghini Veneno, which is now rocking a custom-made 1.9-liter tri-turbo V6 engine, pumping out 3,069 horsepower, which, by the way, is around 450 horsepower less than the current record car from Joe. It's also got 2,295 newton meters of torque, and it weighs in at just 999 kilos, same as the Sesto Elemento. And that was just a small taster of the straight line performance. The cornering performance is even more impressive. That's what I mainly worked on to get a good lap time. And after the lap, we're gonna test the acceleration times, the top speed, how many G's we can pull off the line and through corners. There are loads more things to look forward to, so stick around for those. And if you wanna see more ridiculous Forza videos in the future, please subscribe. I really wanna hit 400K by the end of the year, so every single sub really helps. the editing, I'm gonna add some nice dev build custom cinematics to really convey the speed of that car. It might look like it's just got endless grip and it's full throttle everywhere. No, a little bit too much movement on that controller stick and you're just flying off into the scenery. I'm really happy with that lap. It wasn't perfect by any means. Looking at the previous record, I'll take it. Alrighty then, we are back on the normal map, and since I've just built this, we need to go around a racetrack as fast as possible. I've never actually measured its straight line performance. Before we do our drag run, we're gonna remove the rear wing. Now, it looks kind of odd from the rear, I agree, but the side profile looks so sick. In my opinion, that shark fin right there looks awesome. Let me know which one you prefer, with or without the spoiler. I'm gonna put a little poll right here. Ooh, a little bit of red line there. Come on, Vinino, come on. I know, it's ridiculous. It's too fast. I reckon we can go a little bit quicker if we launch in second gear, because there was an awful lot of wheel spin. Our first gear is just too short to use, so second gear this time around. Still a lot of wheel spin, surprisingly enough, but that's quicker. That has to be quicker. Come on. Surely that was faster. It felt faster. Should we try a rolling start from second? I mean, might as well, just for the funsies. And just boost it in second. Come on. This doesn't get boring. But what about the actual top speed? When you drive around Goliath, you just don't have enough space to really max out that monster of a car, but now we are on the highway. We're gonna see how fast we can really go in a straight line. But before we do that, we're gonna make it a little bit drier just to get the maximum amount of grip. Oh, by the way, can we please make that a feature in future Forza games? Just changing the weather if you want to. Please play around games. I'd really appreciate that. And floor it, come on. Ooh. Jesus. Okay then, I could be wrong there, so we might have to look at the replay, but I'm pretty sure we hit Mach 1 there. So the speed of sound, no match for our mighty Vinino. As weird as that might sound, this is not the fastest car I've ever built in the dev build. I remember, was it a Tesla Dragster? I think it was a Tesla Dragster. I can't remember how fast it was going. I think it was like 4,000 or 5,000 kilometers per hour. We have a G-meter in the game, so we might as well use it right now. And we're gonna see what sort of figures we pull. I'm pretty sure we're gonna break it at some point. I've seen 7! That's neck-breakingly fast. I am by no means a medical expert, but I'm pretty sure 7 Gs off the spot, off the line, would knock out a normal person. I've spotted 9. I don't think anyone's ever built a car in Horizon 3 that could physically knock out the driver just by accelerating. That is nuts. And I think I'm gonna leave it there. I can honestly say this is the most time I've ever spent on a single YouTube video. This took ages to make, but I hope you guys liked it. If you did, please subscribe. I don't post very often, so I'm not gonna spam your sub box, but when I post, I wanna make sure it's interesting, I wanna make sure it's a banger, and I wanna make sure it's something that other people just don't do. That's what I'm going for, so once again, thank you for watching, thank you for subscribing, and until next time, bye. You know what bugs me? Not getting an in-game achievement for doing 50 laps of Goliath. So I created this little trophy right here, a magnet, a custom magnet, the 50 Lap Club magnet, professionally designed from scratch, and you can get one too at racing-marky.com. In fact, you should get one because there are not that many left. Or just treat yourself to some beautifully made PI and drivetrain stickers.